Shana Tova, everybody.
Shana Tova.
First, just a few announcements that if you are here and have a cell phone, go ahead and turn it off. And we know that should we need, God forbid or whatever, the exit is that door. And friends on Zoom, hi, and you'll be muted. Make sure that you mute yourself for the entire service. At the end of the service, feel free to unmute and say Shana Tova. And if you have any sort of other tabs open on your computer, feel free to close them. And then we can be here all in this very way together. Please, for those of us here, keep your masks on. And, you know, I offered last night that this was not exactly the high holidays that we thought we would be having. I did not imagine that last year we would once again not be all together in the same space, in the same place. I certainly did not imagine that we would be simultaneously coming out of one pandemic with the easing of mitigations while at the same time coming back in pandemic with mitigations. Changes, so much to keep track of. And what stays the same, however, is the power of this day. Power of our prayers that we say year after year after year, the melodies that we sing year after year after year. So in the midst of modifications and mitigations, we come back to the power and majesty of this Rosh Hashanah, of this new year. So let's come and settle into this moment. Coming back with gratitude for another year. You'll notice there are changes within the service. It's a little bit shorter. We went with a less is more this year. And yet, it's still very familiar and in so many ways the same. That's the power of ritual and the power of our holy days. So may our prayers and our presence give us everything we need coming into this 5782 new year. Shana Tova, everybody.
Shana Tova.
We'll begin with a nigun. Shana Tova. We'll continue on page 121. You have taught us, guard yourselves well, take good care of your lives. Your word calls to us, do no harm to yourself. Do not weaken or exhaust yourself. In gratitude for the gift of our bodies, we pray for a year of renewed health and replenished strength. May caring for our bodies become our daily practice. May we be attentive to our need for proper food, sleep, exercise. Let no injury come to others through our acts or failure to act. But let our mitzvah be this: to build a just society in which care is a birthright and the blessing of health the responsibility of all. Baruch atah Adonai, Rofei Chol Basar, Umafli Va'asot. 123. Precious above is the soul within me, a spark of childhood innocence, curious, hopeful, loving, and good. Whatever I've done, wherever I've gone wrong, however I've been hurt, I know its light still shines. May I return and reconnect with a part of me that belongs to you, my divine core, eternal and incorruptible. Baruch atah Adonai, asher biyado nefesh kol chai, veruach kol basar ish. We begin our service recognizing that our soul is pure and the body good. And we return to seeing the miracle of this life, year after year, on this Rosh Hashanah, the world's birthday. We are witness to the miracles. We are witness to acts of goodness, goodness that we receive and that we give. And so we praise God as witnesses to miracles. We praise God now and forever. The Baruch Hu is on page 142. If you're able, please rise. Source of blessing, our eternal God, your power fills the cosmos, shaping light, creating darkness, making peace, and fashioning all things. Infinite light is preserved in life's treasure house. Lights from the darkness, said God, it was so. 144. In love, you bring light to the earth and its creatures. Your goodness renews the creation each day. Infinite, varied, and rich are your works, divine artist, all of them wrought with wisdom. The whole earth is teeming with life. Awestruck by the universe, work of your hands, let all life bless you, praise you, and celebrate the beauty of your lights. Or chadash al tzion ta'ir v'nizkeh ulanu mehera le'oro. May you shine a new light on Zion, and may we soon be privileged to share in that light. Baruch atah Adonai, Yotzer HaMe'orot, page 146. Love abundant, love unstinting. Our God, you have enfolded us in love. Tender compassion, beyond all bounds, your precious gift. Our fathers and mothers gave you their trust, and you gave them Torah, laws by which to live. For their sake, teach us as well. Grace us with your guidance. Loving Father, merciful Mother of us all, grant us clear understanding that we may listen, learn, and teach, preserve, practice, and fulfill with love every lesson of your Torah. May learning your Torah light up our eyes. May our hearts embrace your mitzvot, unite us in love and reverence for you that we may never feel ashamed of our deeds. We have trusted in your great and holy name. And now let us celebrate at last the joy of your salvation. Bring us in peace from the four corners of the earth together. Lead us with upright pride to the land that is ours. For you are a God of miracles and wonders. From all the peoples of the earth, you sought us out and brought us near to your great enduring truth. So with love, we acknowledge and proclaim that you are one. Baruch atah Adonai, Habocher ba'amo Yisrael ba'ahava. Our praise to you, Adonai. You have singled out your people, Israel, with love.
Shema. Oh,
Please be seated, and we'll turn to page 152 for the Ve'ahavta.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha b'chol levavcha u'b'chol nafshecha u'b'chol me'odecha ve'hayu ha'devarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha היום הלבנך, ושיננתם לבנך, ודיברת בם, ושבתך בביתך, ובלכתך ותרך, ושוכבך ותקומך, וקשרתם לאות על ידך, והיו לתותפות בין עיניך. וכתבתם במזוזות ביתך ובישריך למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותי והייתם כראשים לאלוהיכם אני אדוני אלוהיכם אשר הוציאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים, להיות לכם אלוהים, אני אדוני אלוהיכם.
Page 159. I try to walk the road of Judaism. Embedded in that road, there are many jewels. One is Mark Sabbath, and one civil rights, and one kashrut, and one honor your parents, and one study of Torah, and one you shall be holy. There are at least 613 of them, and they are of different shapes and sizes and weights. Some are light and easy for me to pick up, and I pick them up. Some are too deeply embedded for me, so far at least, though I get a little stronger by trying to extricate the jewels as I walk the street. Some perhaps I shall never be able to pick up. I believe that God expects me to keep on walking Judaism street and to carry away whatever I can of its commandments. I do not believe that God expects me to lift what I cannot, nor may I condemn my fellow Jew who may not be able to pick up even as much as I can. 164.
חדשה שבחו בעולים לשמך השפת הים יחד כולם חודו בהים לכו ואמרו ארוני ימלוך לעולם ועד צור ישראל בעזרת ישראל עובדי החינומך יהודה וישראל בועלנו ארוני צוות שמו קדוש ישראל ברוך אתה אדוני נאה ישראל אמן
אדוני שפתי תפתח ופי יגיד תהילתך open up my lips God that I may open up my lips that I may be able to declare your praise. If you're able, we'll stand page 166 for the Amidah.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu ve'Elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzhak, Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka as deep to me. Vikane ha'akul is a fairest day of old Vimahot. Who may be Yulalit Nevinehem Leman Shemo Be'ahava. Zochenu, zochenu lechaim. Zochenu, zochenu lechaim. Zochenu, zochenu lechaim. Melech hafetz b'chaim. Echodinu b'sefer hachaim. Echodinu b'sefer hachaim. Echodinu b'sefer hachaim.
Please be seated. Page 175. Unatana Tokef. Let us embrace the day and its holiness, for this day is a throne of goodness and power. When the people of Israel do God's will, they strengthen God's power on high. Join me. But when the people of Israel fail to do God's will, they weaken, if one might say it, God's great power on high. So let this day recall your power and ours. Let it remind us of our promises kept and broken, as we remind you of yours. Let this day be a throne of forgiveness, for today we are the accountants of our souls, the navigators of our hearts, seeking wholeness in a new direction. And we seek you through signs of your presence in the arc of sacred history. I make this covenant not with you alone, but with those who are standing here with us this day and with those who are not. God of ages past and future, God of this day, as you were with our mothers and fathers, be with us as well. 178. On Rosh Hashanah, we plunge like swimmers into a sea of words. On Yom Kippur, the sea rises, then crests, and we emerge, sealed by the wax, warmed by the fire of braided candle. The new year is like a trailhead opening wide before us. The day of fasting, narrow, breathless, so quick to close. We contemplate a new year, and this we know. Some of us will live and some of us will die. Some will die young and some very old, some by water and some by fire, some by sword and some by beast, some by hunger and some by thirst, some by plague and some by earthquake, some by stoning and some by strangling. Some of us will feel at ease, some of us will be restless, some of us will have peace of mind, some will have strife, some will be tranquil, some will be tormented, some will be raised high, some will be brought low, some will have riches, some will be impoverished. Even so, the way we act, the way we speak, the way we meet God's image in ourselves and in others, these things have great power to make our lives better. How about matter? Wishful thinking. Therefore, let us make whole the broken shards, green and thick the withering grass. Let the wind fill us with urgency for life. Let dreams give birth to justice and goodness. God of holiness, God of hope, let us glimpse your truth as we attach our hope to yours. Utshuva, utfila, utstaka, me'avirin et roa hagzera. Together, but through return to the right path, through prayer and righteous giving, we can transcend the harshness of the decree. You are everything that we praise you for, slow to anger and quick to forgive. You do not wish the death of sinners, but urge them to return from their ways and live. Until the day of death, you wait for them. You accept them at once if they return. Since you created us, you know our impulses. We are but flesh and blood. Page 184. We return to the tefillah, the Amidah. If you're able, please rise. Page 196. Our God and God of the generations before us, May a memory of us ascend and come before you. May it be heard and seen by you, winning your favor and reaching your awareness, together with the memory of our ancestors, the memory of your sacred city, Jerusalem, and the memory of your people, the family of Israel. May we be remembered for safety, well-being, and favor, for love and compassion, and for life and for peace on this day of remembrance. Zochreinu Adonai Eloheinu bo l'tova. Amen. Ufokdenu vo livracha. Amen. Vehoshienu vo l'chaim. Amen. Eternal our God, remember us. Amen. Be mindful of us. Amen. And redeem us for a life of goodness and blessing.
Amen.
Take a moment for silent prayer. In each service, whether a daily service or a high holy day service, there is time for silent prayer. The rabbis who wrote the prayer service knew that while words on the page, while formatted prayers serve a purpose, there is nothing like the prayers from our hearts. So after we perhaps open the heart a bit by praying or by just listening and tuning in, we might feel a sense of maybe urgency, sense to make right wrongs. We might use that silent prayer time to ask for help. We might use that time to ask for healing. So next in the service comes the prayer for healing. Misha Beirach is on page 244. And if you have prayers for those in need of healing, of God's blessings, if you're in the sanctuary, call those names out loud. And please, if you're on Zoom, put the names of friends and loved ones who are in need of our prayers and God's blessings into the chat. Take them all in. We include all those who are ill, and we pray, may the one who brought blessings to our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and to our mothers, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, bring the blessing of health to those who are ill. May the Holy One, blessed source of life and healing, sustain and strengthen them with compassion and restore them to full health without delay. For all who struggle against illness, that renewal of spirit and renewal of body come soon, and together we say, Amen. Amen.
Strength.
to Avinu Malkeinu, page 223. If you're able, please rise. Avinu Malkeinu Shema Kolenu. Avinu Malkeinu, Almighty and Merciful, hear our voice. Avinu Malkeinu Chatanu Lefanecha, together. Avinu Malkeinu, we have strayed and sinned before you. Avinu Malkeinu Chamol Aleinu V'al Olaleinu V'tapenu. Avinu Malkeinu, have compassion on us and our families. Avinu Malkeinu Kalei Deber V'chere V'ra'av Me'aleinu. Avinu Malkeinu, halt the onslaught of sickness, violence, and hunger. Avinu Malkeinu, kalei kol tsar umastin me'aleinu. Avinu Malkeinu, halt the reign of those who cause pain and terror. Avinu Malkeinu, kotvenu b'sefer chayim tovim. Avinu Malkeinu, enter our names in the book of lives well lived. Avinu Malkeinu, chadesh aleinu shana tova. Avinu Malkeinu, renew for us a year of goodness. Avinu Malkeinu, chonenu v'anenu, ki ein benu ma'asim, ase'i manu tzedaka v'chesed v'hoshienu. Avinu Malkeinu, almighty and merciful, answer us with grace, for our deeds are wanting. Save us through acts of justice and love.
Avinu Malkeinu, Avinu Malkeinu, Avinu Malkeinu, Aneinu Vaneinu, Nien Vanu Masin, Asimu.
Adonai, Adonai, El Rachum V'Chanun, page 228. Adonai, Adonai, God, compassionate, gracious, endlessly patient, loving and true, showing mercy to the thousandth generation, forgiving evil, defiance, wrongdoing, and granting pardon.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Gadol Shemo, Gadlul Yeranaiti. Unerumema shemo yachtav leha Adonai hagedula hagibura hatiberet hanetzat hahor ki ho bashamayim uvavet ki ho bashamayim Adonai, Amam Lecha.
Torah reading, the Akedah, it's called, the Parsha, is on page 240 of the Machzor. This is a portion we read each year on Rosh Hashanah. Some say that it is the most difficult of portions. Some of the lessons, however, are, there's a lesson of hospitality when Abraham welcomes guests into his tent. Some say it's an importance about speaking out for social justice. It's the story of Sodom and Gomorrah, where Abraham says, asks God, argues with God. Seriously, God, you're going to destroy some towns just for a few bad apples? Some say it's a question of faith. God asks Abraham to sacrifice his beloved son, Isaac. Go on to Mount Moriah, says God, commands God. Mount Moriah, if you've been to Israel, or even if you haven't, it's the mountain behind the Western Wall where the two great mosques are. It says, go sacrifice your son Isaac, and Abraham, like no questions asked. He goes ahead. So we read this portion, we read, Abraham and Isaac go up the mountain. And just when Abraham was about to fulfill the commandment, God calls out, Abraham, Abraham. And Abraham was so intent on following through with that commandment, he does not hear God stop him. It's Isaac who, filled with fear, hears God. Some people say that Abraham shows us what it means to have faith. Some people, and this is the camp that I fit in, say Isaac shows us what it means to have faith. That in the midst of great fear and tragedy or potential tragedy, we can still hear the voice of the Holy One. So, the Aliyah is on page 230. And if you wish to offer an Aliyah in hopes that this year you will be able to hear and to feel holiness, please at your seat stand and offer the Aliyah with me. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamvorach, Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Va'ed, Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Va'ed, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amim, V'natan Lanu et Torato, Baruch Ata Adonai Notin HaTorah. Just be seated. Vayhi achar hadvarim ha'ele v'halohim nisa et Abraham. Vayomer elav Abraham, vayomer hineni, vayomer kachna, et bincha et yechidcha, asher ahavta et yitzchak, velechecha el eretz Moriah, veyalehu sham leola, al echad harim asher amar elecha. Vayishchem Avraham baboker, v'yichavosh et hamaro, v'yikach et shnei narav ito, v'et yitzchak beno. V'yivakatz elah, v'yakum v'elech, el ha'makom asher amar lo ha'elohim. Vayom Ashlishi Vaisavraham et Einav Vayarat HaMakom Merachok Vayomer Avraham El Nerav Shvulachem Po Imachamur Vani V'harnar Nechadot Ko V'nishtachaveh V'nashuva Alechem Vaykach Avraham Et Atzela Vayasam Yitzchak Beno V'yakach B'yado Et Ha'esh V'tamach Chelet velechu shnehem yachdav vayomer Yitzchak el Avraham avi vayomer avi vayomer hineni beni vayomer hine ha'esh v'ha'etzim vayehaseh le'olam Vayomer Avraham Elohim Yir Eloasa Ve'ola Beni Ve'lechu Shnehem Yachdav. Can stand or sit to join me in the concluding blessing.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher natan lanu Torat emet V'chayei olam ata b'tocheinu Baruch ata Adonai
Let's remain standing for Vezot HaTorah. We'll put the Torah away.
Vezot HaTorah Asher Samutra Lifnei B'nei Yisrael Api Adonai Miyad Moshe Lai Dai 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 dai.
In 2018, I attended an 8-day silent retreat at Spirit Rock, a 400-acre meditation center near West Marin County, California. A silent retreat is exactly what it sounds like. It was very quiet. No TV, no cell phone, email, or social media. My family had access to me only for a dire emergency, and then they would have to call the retreat center, who would have to come and find me. No books, music, or news. Insight meditation and expert lessons from our teachers were to be our guides, connecting back to oneself, to the heart, and to that which grounds us. In Hebrew, this kind of retreat might be referred to as a shemitah, a period of complete renewal and refrain from consumerism, outside distractions, and work. A retreat like this can offer a near reset of the nervous system, and at its core is about rest. The sacred concept of rest, of shemitah, is first found in the Torah in the book of Exodus, We read, you shall sow your land for 6 years and gather its field, gather its yield, but in the seventh, you shall let the land lie fallow. Let the needy among your people eat of it, and when they leave, let the wild beasts eat. You shall do the same with your vineyards and your olive groves. The sabbatical year, Shemitah, is a commandment, a divine order to let the land lie fallow and the farmers that they too might rest. Also during the seventh year, Leviticus teaches there should be no selling or focusing on buying. The hungry are to take what they need freely from our fields. All debts are to be forgiven. The Shemitah year is the Torah's ultimate vision for our world. It's rooted in social justice, human dignity, and care of the earth, all of which cannot be accomplished without rest. Rabbi Jonathan Slater writes, Shemitah is part of a system organized to direct our hearts and minds to greater clarity, to deepen awareness of what it means to be human in this world, and how to serve God, the world, existence itself for goodness and for life. We are a society that goes and goes and goes, and many of us feel so far behind with things because of work or obligations that we spend weekends and our vacations when we're able to take them, either catching up with chores or trying to squeeze so much into our free time that we don't get any real rest from it. It's the we need a vacation from our vacation mentality, and it makes no sense. And it is not helpful to our well-being. Not to mention this past year, most of us have not traveled. We have not had a vacation or really much time off at all. The pandemic has caused us a whole new category of worry. We have spent the year fearful, protective. Many of us have been cooped up in the house with kids and have been called to be teachers, therapists, and playdates. Grandparents have changed their schedules entirely to replace the role of preschool and grade school. We have missed doctor's appointments. We have missed seeing friends. The level of stress we and this country have endured has been harmful in every way. And we are exhausted. Many of us frequently feel fatigued and burnt out. The concept of Shemitah, to rest so that we might replenish, that we are to let the land, our bodies, our minds rest, is an important idea and plays a vital role in not only our own health and well-being, but it is critical towards accomplishing Torah's vision of a just society, even though it seems counterintuitive that we will ultimately produce more by doing less. Holy rest and its significance and priority in our life are not solely, of course, to be explored during the Shemitah year. The very next verse in Exodus, after the mitzvah of Shemitah, is the mitzvah of observing Shabbat. We read, the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. In it you shall do no manner of work, neither you nor your son nor your daughter nor your male servant nor your female servant. The great 19th century Hasidic Rebbe commentator Sfat Emet beautifully compares Shabbat rest to that of being in Noah's Ark. During the week, we are striving and preoccupied with our daily tasks and concerns, but on Shabbat, we are told to let go and find calm and connection. We are to take shelter in the shalom of Shabbat, just as Noah and his family took shelter in the ark, appearing on dry land only when the storm was over, only then finding rebirth and renewal. The Svat Emet teaches here that with the holy rest, we might be directed back to our core being and aliveness and emerge from it with a new vital force. The power of this rest, Svat Emet teaches, is that it brings a new source of vitality, a renewal, a revitalization of our very selves. While it is impractical for most of us to take a complete year-long sabbatical or even a weekly full 24 hours, as the commandment to observe Shabbat dictates, we can ask, and I think after the last year and a half that we've all suffered through, myself included, we have to ask, how can we give ourselves a break? How might we find a measure of rest, a moment of solitude? This is the time to ask ourselves, in what ways do I need to rest? How would taking a break from, let's say, watching the news help my nervous system? Similarly, how would taking a break from social media free up parts of my day, perhaps to perhaps work on self-care or to find joy? And if I do rest during the day or I don't feel all that stressed, we could ask, what might allow me additional sources of peace or of renewal, maybe returning to hobbies or things that bring us joy? Today is Rosh Hashanah, the beginning of the new year, 5782. And on this very day, we enter the seventh year in the Jewish calendar and begin the year of Shemitah. Today is the day. We start taking on a period, a year-long period of letting go, of giving ourselves a break. Personally, I'm glad that the Shemitah has arrived here and now. It's one thing to say, I'm going to rest soon, or I want to go on vacation. It's another thing to be commanded to let go. Whatever we decide we might do to offer our mind and our body rest this year, I'd like us as a community to begin the Shemitah year right now, together. So let's take a moment. I invite all of us, if it's comfortable for you to do so, to close your eyes or gaze softly downward or ahead. And just notice that you're breathing. There's an in-breath and an out-breath. If focusing on the breath isn't comfortable for you, just notice how your body feels in the seat, that your body might relax. Just notice. And if thoughts come in like, why am I doing this? Or I don't want to do this. That's nice. Just greet them and allow them to leave as they will. How does it feel to sink into your seat and rest? Notice how tired you might feel. Notice how the body is feeling, or the thoughts that come in and go. I'm just noticing just here in the seat. Breathing and being. I'll be quiet for a moment while we rest. And open the eyes if they're closed, if you feel like it. Tell you. Doing this almost brings me to tears. It's a gift to have a moment of quiet and release during the day. Our bodies, minds, have held on to so much. We've tried to keep it together under harsh circumstances of pandemic. We have tried so hard to be resilient, strong, move forward. And now, on the first day of the new year, we don't have to. At this moment, there is no need to be strong, to push through, to act as if we got it together. Right now, let's just note we are commanded to rest. Letting go of all of what we have to do, all of what we have done this past year, for even a moment, is a Shemitah, a holy rest. And it's healing. And it's mending and repairing the world. On this day of creation, Yom Harat Olam, may we each discover ways we can add transformative periods of rest and letting go in our days. For then we, our families, and the world will be blessed in ways we cannot even imagine right now. I wish for each of us a year of ease, holy rest, and many moments of letting go. Shana Tova Umetuka, a sweet and good Shemitah year. Amen. Ken Yehi Ratzon, may this be true. Amen. We'll conclude our service with the Aleinu, page 286. If you're able, please rise.
Aleinu lishabeach le'adon hakol, latet gedula le'yotzei breishit, shelo asanu kigoyei haratzot, ve'lo samanu k'mishpechot ha'adama, shelo sam helkeinu bahem, Vigor aleinu kehol hamonam Anachnu korim umishavim umodim Lifnei melech malei amayim Hakadosh Barehu Ve'neimar v'haya Adonai Vimelech al kol haaretz Vayom ahu, vayom ahu Yehi Adonai echad Ushemohu, ushemohu, ushemohu
Remain standing for Mourner's Kaddish. It's on page 292. On this Yontif, we're in Shloshim for Rebecca Becky Rissman and Brenda Friedland Pangborn. We observe the yard sites of Alice Holberg, Nathan Kamikow, Fran Schoenblum, Rosalia Tanskaya, Davi Cooper, Irving Diamond, Martha Monk, Adele Olaf, Herschel Olaf, Lottie Spitzer, Malka Rosen, Jacob Levitan, Stephen Winternitz, Harold Williams, and it is the first anniversary of the yard site, the first yard site anniversary of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. We remember the 6 million Jews, among them the Jews of Koyatin and Ronich, Czechoslovakia, whose memories we keep alive and whose Torahs we keep in sacred trust. Together, V'yit Kadal, V'yit Kadal, Shemei Rabba, V'yel Hadi, V'yel Lich Machute, V'chayechon, V'yomechon, V'chayeh Dechol Beit Yisrael, Ba'agala, Lizman, Karim, V'imru, Amen. Yehe Shemei Rabba, Mevorach, Le'olam, Olamei, Omaya, Yitparach, V'yishtabach, V'yitpa'ar, V'yitroman, V'yitnase, V'yitadar, V'yitale, V'yitalal, Shmeid, Kudusha, Barichu, Le'ela, Ul'ela, Miko, Birchata, V'shirata, Tushbachata, V'nechamata, Damiran, V'alma, V'imru, Amen. Yehe, Shlama, Rabba, Min Shemaya, V'chayim, Aleinu, V'alko Yisrael, V'imru, Amen. Ose shalom b'mromav, hu yase shalom, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, v'al kol yoshvei tevel, v'imru, amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn and comfort all of us who are bereaved, and we say together, amen. Please be seated. Before we offer the closing song of L'shana Tova Tegateru, we have Tashlik planned for 2 o'clock, but there might be another plan that we are not in control of, and that is rain. So if it is raining, we're not gonna be at Green Lake Knowles Park. We'll be on Zoom, and we'll send those links out as soon as we decide for having outdoor Tashlik. Shana Tova, everybody.
Shana Tova.
Shana Tova, everybody.
Shana Tova.
Shana Tova.